Independence is reporting a five-fold increase in flu cases this year compared to last year. While health officials say it's not time to panic, they say it does paint a clear picture of what we're up against.
A good side to that is that we are on top of what's going on. We're monitoring it. The thing that having five times as many cases right now than what we had a year ago says to us is that we really already have it. You don't wait till the middle of October now to talk about flu.
The Independence Health Department has logged more than 100 new cases of flu for 2 weeks running, compared to less than 20 cases a year ago. And more than 60% are reported in children younger than 18 years old. While not all cases are confirmed to be H1N1, the health director says it's a safe bet because seasonal flu doesn't hit this early. School districts throughout the metro are, of course, dealing with H1N1 absences. They say the kind of numbers they're seeing now, they usually don't see until January or February. Health departments will be placing orders for the H1N1 vaccine this week, but still don't know how much they'll get at one time. They do know high-risk groups get priority, including pregnant women and the very young. But eventually, they expect H1N1 vaccine to be available to everyone. And with the recent spike in flu cases, health officials hope residents take the threat of H1N1 seriously.
It says to us, we better be treating this as something that we can take care of, meaning that if you have a temperature and you have the symptoms of flu, stay home. Don't spread it throughout the community.
And Jones says if you have flu symptoms for several days and are not improving, see a doctor. For those who are anxious about getting the H1N1 vaccine, Jones expects local clinics will be administering the earliest shipments. So check with your doctor's office, especially if you're among the high risk.